Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss about backtracking, which is coming under unit number 5. So let me introduce about the backtracking techniques. It is similar to dynamic programming, which is mainly used for solving algorithmic based problems, and in simple way it is similar to depth first search, which we have already studied in data structures. So let us understand the working of backtracking by using a simple graph. So in this graph I have source vertex as 1 and destination vertex as 6. So we need to traverse from 1 to 6 by using backtracking. So let me start from 1. I am having two adjacent vertex for the vertex 1, which is 2 and 3. So I am starting from 1 and I am traversing towards 2, and from 2 I am having two adjacent vertex. They are 4 and 5. So we can traverse in any one of the side. Let me take 5 as a next traversing vertex. So I am traversing to 5. So after 5 I am not having any vertex which is to be traversed. So this will be taken as a dead end. So I have to go back and I have to visit the another adjacent vertex of vertex 2. So that is 4. So from 5 I have to go back to 2. That is backtracking, which means I am going to previous step of my solution 2. So from 2 I have to go to 4. And from 4 I am having two adjacent vertex. They are 3 and 6. You can choose any one. From 4 I am choosing 6. So at last I reached my destination, that is 6. This is the concept of backtracking. So let me go back to our definitions. There are a lot of definitions available in internet. So one among them is I have highlighted in red color. In backtracking, we first take a step and then we see if this step taken is correct or not, whether it will give a correct answer or not, and if it does not, then we just come back and change our first step. Likewise, lot of definitions are available in internet. So best example to understand the working of backtracking are Enkian's problem, Sudoku, Hamiltonian circuit, subset sum problem, maze generation, etc. So next we are going to discuss the first example of backtracking, that is Enkian's problem, which is very very important for examination point of view. So let me explain the Enkian's problem first. Enkian's means, N means it can be anything like 1 to N numbers. So if I want to place 1 Qn means the board should be taken as 1 cross 1. If I want to place 4 Qn's means the board taken should be 4 cross 4 matrix, which means a square matrix. So in this I have highlighted some points which are like no two Qn should each other in same row, column in diagonal, and this is a condition which is used for placing any Qn in a chessboard. So for example, if my n value is 1, if my n value is 1, it is not at all possible to place this Qn in chessboard. Likewise for 2 and 3, it is not possible to place all the n coins in the chessboard. So we have to neglect all these three numbers and we can start from the 4 Qn problem. It is very important. So we will discuss one by one by using two methods. So the taken Qn count is 4 and chessboard size is 4 cross 4. So So the only condition we need to keep in mind is no two queens should attack each other either in row wise or in column wise or in diagonal order. We need to take care of all the three properties and we will find solution one by one, and we need to provide all the optimal solution rather than single solution. That is a very important thing for solving this problem. So let us solve one by one by using diagrammatic approach. First, I have a chessboard 4x4. So my intention is I have to place all the four queens in the chessboard. So I am representing using Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. Now, first, we can place the queens either by following row order or by column order. It is up to you. We can follow any one of the technique. Okay, now in this I am following column wise approach for placing all the four queens. First, I placed my Q1 in column number 1, which is the starting point 00 or 11. Now in second point, place second queen in column number 2. So I represented Q1, all the other like column and also rows are highlighted by using cross marks, which means we should not place any other queens in this boxes. So to place second queen, I have only two places in third row and fourth row, which is coming under second column. So we can choose any one. Since we are following the hierarchical order, we can take Q2 in third row, which is in second column. Now third step. In third step, I have to place the third queen, but to place the third queen in third column, there is no proper places. So at this situation, I have to go back and backtrack to next position of Q2, which means in previously Q2 is chosen at row number 3, but now I have to place this Q2 in row number 4. Since there is a situation like it is not possible to place third queen at column number 3, so we are going for backtracking to second column for placing Q2 at fourth row instead of third row. So after updation, the diagram is given in step number 4. Now step number 5. Now after updating the diagram, we are having a place like Q3 can be placed at second row, which is coming under third column. Now look at the step number 6. If I want to place my fourth queen in row in column number 4, there is no proper places, so there is a conflict. So we have to go back to the previous, or we have to backtrack to the previous step for placing the all the four coins properly. So now we are going to backtrack to starting point. Since we are not having proper places under Q2 and Q3, we are going back to Q1. So we are starting from the first level. So instead of placing Q1 at first row, we are placing at second row. This is the updation in the problem. Now if I place Q1 at second row, we need to look back the row wise and column wise and also in diagonal order. So we can place Q2 only at this location here. In look at the seventh step, we are having only one empty boxes where we can place the queue number 2. So I have placed my queue number 2. Again, I highlighted the cross mark where we cannot place any other coin at this situation. Now in step number 9, so by taking this third column, we are having one empty box, we can place easily our third queen at this column number 3. Now step number 10, after placing So look at step number 10. In step number 10, before placing Q4, we can look back to step number 9, where we have the empty box in column number 4. By taking this input, we can place our Q4 in step number 10. Now all the 4 Q's are placed at proper places where there is no conflict, like row wise, column wise or diagonal wise meeting point. So this is one optimal solution, and second optimal solution is this one. So you can try by yourself by placing the first coin at third row. Since we have the first optimal solution by starting the Q1 at position number 2, we are having solution number 2 at the row number 3. Likewise, you can try for a queens problem also, where you have to use this method or either another method which is known as state space tree. Now we will discuss fortune's problem by using state space tree. So I have taken the empty box which is known as roots, and now from this I am going to include two children which is having two options, like in this